Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Tech Tian. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about advanced custom fields. For those of who don't know, this is a Metabox framework, framework or Metabox plugin, whatever you say. If I go to my install plugins, you can see I have this installed in my WordPress website, and the current version that I'm using right now is 5.9.1. And you can go and install it. If you want to install it with the TGM plugin activation, you can do that as well. So let me update this pick list right now. This is saying that update, 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 and I'm not updating. So let's update pick list. So one thing that I wanted to say is advanced custom fields is like one of the finest plugin out there for Metabox, and it also has this amazing front end toolkit that you can use. So if you just go to custom fields, and here you can see currently there is no field groups. I can just add a new one, and here I can just name it anything that I want. So for the moment, let's name this test one, and here you can see there are a bunch of things that you can add through this plus add field. So whenever you click this one, here you can see this is asking for a field label, then this is asking for a field name, and here you can select your type. So for the first one, let me just type name, and if I type name, you can see the field name is automatic field. The field name automatically took a name, an ID, which is name, and later we will use this ID to retrieve the value. So like the first one is name, and for the name I can just get anything from here. So for the moment, let's take this text, and here you can put some default value as well. Then you can give some logic as well. So let's just add another field. Let's close this one. So this is going, you can see some of the things here as well, like the label, that name, and the type. And the next thing that I want to have is, let's have a text area. So for that, I will just write for text area what you can write. You can just write a description. I can just write job description. So you can see it automatically took job description as the ID, and here I can just write text area. So you can see I can give some value as default value as well. So for the moment, let's close this one as well. Next, I want to take another field, like the phone number. So I can just write the name as the phone number, and here it will automatically pick up the field ID, and here I have to save this as number. Then we are good to go. So let's close this one as well. Let's take another value. The next value can be email or URL. So let's take an URL. So for the URL, let's take a website address. And you will see this will be filled automatically. So for website address, URL, let's close this one as well. Then let's take another field, and this one can be shown as image. So let's take image, and let's have this one called photo, maybe. Okay, so this took photo for itself. And here you can see you can decide what kind of format you want as return. It has image array, it has URL, it has image ID. So whatever you select over here, this will return that back to you. So let's close this field as well. So next, I want, what can I say? So for now, let's have these couple of things. And here you can actually set your location. So for the moment, I am just saying that this should only show when the page template is, when the page temp, when this is post. So show when this is equal to post. So post type is equal to post. So whenever WordPress will see that something is a post, it will show me these five things: name, job description, phone number, website address, then photo. So let's just publish this one, and this is called test one. So right now, if I go to my field group, custom fields, you can see we have one custom fields, and that is called test one. So if I just go to a post, let's go to all post, and let's go to sample text. And in the sample text right now, here you can see we have name, we have this job description, we have phone number, we have an website address, and we can also attach an image. And one thing that you can see as well over here is there are a couple other things that you can see over here that I made with the Picklist plugin. So the Picklist plugin is currently not here, but yeah, so you can just have anything over here, and if you just update that, your data will be saved. So this is how you can create some meta box for your post. So I guess that is pretty self-explanatory for you guys. Let me know whether you have any confusion or not, and I'll be seeing you guys in my next video. Till next time, take care.